Thomas the Tank Engine Friends, Winnie Railway Adventure Stories, episode 36. A perfect grant, a dookie grant, a grandpuppy grandson. One day, two catapults, two expressions at one. He was passing along the line with it. This would get him a new grandson for sure. He peeked himself. He tooted his whistle all the way. And the engines were cheering for him. They went, "Come on, Duke," said the engines. "Come on, Sir Cranky. You can do this." It was noon right now at the time. As he was going to go select some more passengers for his train, he soon passed away. He passed him proudly. He found only Mighty Max there. They were ready for the grand opening. It was on that Wednesday. And also Mr. Percival came to see it. So he's had a few announcements. "I would like you to enjoy this Duke's new brand sign. It's the most famous brand sign on Sodor. It's a very big honor being run by Norwegian engines. Good luck, Duke, on your new branch line. I hope you enjoy it very much." All the Norwegian engines tooted their whistle. Well, Derek even came. "Congratulations, Duke," said Derek. "And I would like you to be as we have our first train to be pulled by him, by Duke today." Duke passed away with his first ever branch on his train. "Congratulations," said his two coaches, old slow coach and the coach Duke got to name himself, Clarabelle. Well, they were his two. They were the coaches he would be pulling on his dance line. "So we feel very, very, very proud of you. And you," they said, "we need to go pick up our first passengers ever. They soon passed away. Cranky, he said just in time, "Good job, Duke." He couldn't see it. It was too far. He was taking a water break. It was a quick one, though. He soon finished the train. It was finally Duncan's turn to take a train, though. And Duke got into a sign and Duncan passed away with his first ever train on Duke's branch line. That's enough light to Duncan. The train wouldn't be as long as Duke, though. But the passengers still liked him. Duncan puffed in and finished. Meanwhile, it was Phyllis Freddy's turn to take a train. This would be the same in the length as Duke's. And the passengers loved Freddy. He was Phyllis also.
He was not afraid of anything.
If he wouldn't, the Freddy's trains would not be going at the same going to the docks, though. He would just go past it. When he went on to the
onto the viaduct. It up. Bush tooted did his horn at Freddie. Freddie whistled and he turned. An Iroh shoe came in. Did I miss it at all? Yeah, unfortunately. Oh, that's okay. You can come back with me. Freddie, Iroh shoe did that. Why were you not here? You missed the entire celebration. Oh, I'm so sorry, said Iroh shoe. Freddie, you puffed in. Freddy Mac said, congratulations. We will all be doing good things also, said Mr. Percival. So, is to handle the congratulated Duke. And Freddy was fearless enough to tell Thomas, who was very, Thomas was proud though. Just proud, not furious though. But Skylarly was taking his first train. There would be some trouble with his train. He lost a spring. I feel all confident, he said. His driver came to examine it. No, on your first branch, Einstein, you just finish it up. We'll take it to the works immediately, though. No, you can just mend me yourselves, said Skylarly. Oh, we can. Yeah, we forgot about that. I feel like I should derail any moment. He came in crooked. He was mended immediately. It can only take freight cars nowadays. Lady took her first train and had the same thing happen. But the coaches hated Lady. They derailed her. And the passengers had to help her back on the road. She looked sadly back to where she was. I can't move all the coaches anymore. Mr. Percival is in charge of the branch sign. The assistant. Assistant manager. Duke is really the manager. They're made for you. Derek wanted to come back to the closer to the celebration. She decided to go do that. He told all the idiots for a while he was headed there. I could take Lady's train. Derek said, this is fun. Oh, don't I look nice? He asked the coaches. Oh, you do, the coaches. You're a nice diesel. So too bad we can't be pulled. I'm so sorry about Rusty. He can't be pulled by you. We didn't cause the derailment with Lady. It was just the bridge. Yeah, I know, said Derek. Good job. You can be part of the branch line also, Derek. And all the, of course, said Duke, you can. Lady went to go to the works to be mended so she could pull coaches again. An engine like me, can't pull in trains like the young ones can. They can if they're mended. And soon Lady returned to me. He had a new look. She looked like a more sensible engine also. So, well, how do you feel, Saduke? Oh, much better. First Lady, when she was just trying to see how well she could do, she managed going over the bridge, but spun around. Okay, you're weird like that, yeah. Yeah. Lady, yeah, I'm so sorry. I can't be part of the branch line, coach trains. You can just pull the goods trains. Trains? Yeah, they said. As they were preparing a good train for Lady. See? The end of part one.